Otter Place restaurant. We're making pan roasted pork chop with blueberry shallot sauce.
Correct.
Sounds delicious. I'm a big fan of pork chops. Yeah. I feel like people always forget that it's, you know, another meat that you can eat.
They do. A lot of people tend to go for chicken or beef and a lot of seafood, but we're going to do pork today.
Okay. Well, let's run down the ingredients.
Sure. We have salt and pepper, just some vegetable oil. We have lemon juice, sugar, shallots, unsalted butter, white balsamic vinegar, fresh blueberries that are from local farms around the area, and we have some organic pork chops.
Okay. I couldn't resist the blueberries already. Tell me how you make the shallot sauce. The blueberry shallot sauce, because I'm assuming the sugar goes with the blueberries,
yep.
Right?
We're going to melt down some butter, add our shallots to it. We're going to add a little bit of sugar to that. We will add our blueberries so that they start to break down and create a sauce. We'll finish it with a little bit of white balsamic, some lemon juice, and then the natural pectin and the blueberries will help thicken that
sauce. And then the pork chops, what, the salt and pepper, I'm assuming?
Yep, just salt and pepper on them. That's it.
And then you just make them in the pan?
Yep, we're going to make them in the pan. We'll finish them in the oven, and then we'll put the sauce over it, and I have a few other things to add with it just so it creates like a full meal.
Is this a popular dish at Water Place?
Actually, this is an honor menu.
No.
With the blueberries coming almost to the end of their season, we're just trying to use them up as like a special, so that's what we created for that.
You made it special for us.
I did.
And for me, because I will say one thing. I said this before. I'm Porchies, and I mean, pork chops were a staple in my house for sure.
Yeah.
So I can't wait. Pork chop with blueberry shallot sauce.
Yeah.
All right, so you're making the sauce now?
We are.
Okay.
So I have a pan going. It's hot, and we are going to add a couple tablespoons of butter, which has started to melt. And then if you want to add some of the sliced shallots right into there.
Okay.
So we're going to do that.
I'm going to let you handle this.
Okay. and then you just want to mix them around a little bit so that they get coated in the butter. And we're going to add a little bit of pepper to it.
Okay.
You are going to add your blueberries.
Ooh.
Runaway blueberries.
All those blueberries?
Yeah, we're gonna make enough sauce for the four pork chops.
What happened to these blueberries? They'll like melt, I'm assuming?
Yeah, the skins will start to break down, and blueberries have a natural pectin in them, so they actually will thicken your sauce for you.
Oh, all right.
So you don't have to add any like cornstarch or slurry to it.
Something I didn't know you would add anyways, so that's a good thing.
So from here, we are going to add a little bit of sugar, just because the blueberries are a little sweet, but they, with the acid from the lemon juice and the white balsamic, we're going to want to just sweeten them up a little bit more.
Nice. How long will this take?
This actually just takes maybe about 3 to 4 minutes to make, if that.
Okay.
So we're going to add our lemon juice and then about a tablespoon worth of white balsamic. And again, this helps create that sauce for your blueberries.
Well, it smells delicious already, and I'm starving, so I may have to take these blueberries back with me over there to the couch, so. Back in the Rhode Show kitchen one last time with Chef Andrea from Water Place Restaurant. It is a busy weekend. We had water fire here, which means I'm sure your place is going to be packed.
Yeah, we're pretty packed. We still do have a few reservations left, so feel free to call. And definitely, if you're looking for the farther into the season, definitely give a call because it does book up about a month in advance for water fire.
That's good to know. Good advice. All right, where do we stand on our pork chop dish?
So we have a pan that's preheating, and we are going to add a little bit of oil to that and let that heat. And then if you want to season your pork chops, you can do that, and they can go right into the pan.
Okay, so just what, little salt, little pepper?
Yeah, little salt, little pepper.
That's all you put on it, salt and pepper.
The sauce, you want this? Yeah, you want the sauce to give it some flavor. So,
is this too much? Is this too little?
Fine. What?
Okay, and does it get seasoned on both sides?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
And then they can go right into the pan.
I don't know if I trust me either. I'm gonna trust you with that, Michaela. Okay.
All right.
And then right into the pan.
Right into the pan. Yep.
Go. Ooh, hear that sizzle?
So you want, because we are pan roasting them, you want your pan to be hot when they go in so that it gives a nice golden brown crust onto it.
I'd say that's hot.
And, yep, you want to wait.
That's not kind of hot.
You'll want to wait till they release to flip them over. So while those are doing that, we'll start our side dishes. So here we have a mushroom risotto.
Ooh.
And then in the pan we have some butter melting, and you can put your arugula
in there.
We're
going to put that in there?
Yep.
Oh, I thought we were eating this crust. Put everything in it?
Yep, just put it all in.
Okay. Well, I get to wear this as a hat now.
Sure.
Will that work like spinach? Is that going to shrink down?
Yep, it's going to shrink down just like spinach would. So it'll just season with salt and pepper. And again, you're not going to go crazy with seasonings just because it will you're going to have the sauce and everything else with
it. Yeah, you have so many other flavors going on here. Let's talk about this sauce again. It looks so good.
I want to get a spoon and just, like, eat out of it.
Go ahead. You got spoons in that jar right underneath you.
You can see that the blueberries started to release all their juices as well as color the dish. Again, that pectin in it. I finished it with a little bit of butter, and that pectin will also continue to thicken that sauce as it goes. But then once we put it on the pork chop, it'll be good to go.
What an interesting take, too. I mean, the whole, you know, pork chops and applesauce, isn't that swell? You know, you've had the pork chops and the apples, but it's nice to incorporate a different fruit with these.
Yep. And because, so we flipped them over, and because these are thick, we're going to put them in the oven to finish.
Okay. And so time and temp there?
We have it at 400. It'll take about 10 to 15 minutes, depending on how thick your pork chops are.
You've had one that was going in there before.
Oops, sorry. We have a pork chop right here that's cooked, and so then we're just going to arugula again. Doesn't take very long at all. The heat in the pan will continue to cook it, so we're just going to turn it off and toss it a little bit, and you can see that it's wilted down.
That was fast. You have your spoon.
Go
ahead. You know
can
what?
I try that?
Go ahead, Deanna. All right. By itself. Yeah, that's probably nice even alone. Mmm.
Good?
It's really good, yeah. I can't wait to try it with the pork chop now, though.
Now can I try
that? That'll come later.
Yeah, you just take a spoon
for everything. That's all.
All right, so now what we have here is our plate.
Time to plate. Oh, I gotta love this. Now, while you're plating everything up, tell us a little bit more about what's on the menu at Water Place this time of year.
Sure. Right now we have everything from steaks to salads. We have seafood. We do a lot of like fresh seafood from around the area, so little necks, mussels, things like that. We have pizzas on the menu.
What's your favorite?
My favorite? I think the drunken clams have to be my favorite. They have charisse and shallots, and we use a local beer in it.
Oh, that sounds good. All right, you are plating this dish. She's already plated another one. Take a look at that. Now, if you want this recipe, all you have to do is head on to our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com. We're not the only ones having fun today, though. Megan has...